I'll sing you the story of a duck. A duck whose name is Alfred Quack. Yes, Alfred Jodocus Kwak. He comes from a lovely little town. A lovely town in Waterland. Where life is grand. Dipping, bobbing, diving, Alfred's always striving. He seldom wears a frown. You'll never keep a duck down. Dipping, bobbing, diving, Alfred's always striving. He seldom wears a frown. You'll never keep a good duck down. Dipping, bobbing, diving, Alfred's always striving, he seldom wears a frown. Dipping, bobbing, diving, Alfred's always striving, you'll never keep a good duck down.
How long will this rain last? Oh! The river must be flooding!
Oh, no! This is just what I was afraid of. Oh, blast it! What's the matter, Alfred?
Oh, hi, Dad. There's been so much rain, I thought the house might float away.
Your place is on low ground, unlike mine. I was worried about it, and that's why I came.
That's kind of you, Dad.
Don't mention it, but it looks all right for now.
Yes, I agree. I wonder whether it's beginning to clear.
Yep, it's getting a bit brighter, eh?
It'll be the first time in a week. Had floated away while I was asleep.
It could have floated all the way to the sea.
The sea. What an adventure if it had floated out to sea, Dad.
Well, I'm very glad it didn't.
You don't like adventures.
I'm too old for that kind of thing.
No, you're not, Dad. Age doesn't really matter. All that counts is how you feel. That's all.
Maybe you're right, but in the real world, though, you can't ignore age.
Oh my, how beautiful! It's a rainbow, Alfred! Beautiful rainbow! I love rainbows! Do come and see it! That's Winnie!
Let's have a look.
Just look over there.
Ah, that is wonderful. Ah.
The finest rainbow I've ever seen.
You're exaggerating.
But that's just how I feel.
What's that?
Something's falling. Wow!
A bird.
He's out of control. It's Grubby.
He's passed out.
I wonder what happened.
But is he hurt? Is he going to be all right?
I don't know. He doesn't seem injured.
It must be something serious for a bird to fall out of the sky.
Oh. He's waking up. Where am I?
Is it you? Are you the Queen of Rainbow Land?
Hmm? What happened, Grubby?
Is that Alfred? And there's Hank. And, oh, it's you too, Winnie, isn't it?
Whatever happened to you?
This is where I came down.
You were right in front of the house.
Is that beautiful rainbow still there?
No, it's going away now.
I felt that rainbow was calling me, so I wanted to soar up to where it was. But it was always far above my head, and it never came any closer to me.
Anyone would love to get close to a rainbow.
In my case, the rainbow actually called my name.
Mm-hmm.
I almost passed out then. I knew I was falling, and so to avoid landing too hard on the ground, I flapped my wings as hard as I could.
Mm-hmm.
Birds always land softly by instinct, don't they?
Oh, not again.
Oh, it's Professor Boffin.
I think it's about time he learned to drive that thing properly.
Hello, greetings. I saw that rainbow. It reminded me I'm to join Dr. Lovingstone on his expedition.
Today's rainbow is something special.
Maybe you're right. Prof, does that invitation have anything to do with the rainbow?
Yeah, it does. Have you heard the legend which says there's a pot of gold at the foot of every rainbow?
No, I've never heard that.
You haven't? Well, the legend says if you remove the pot of gold from the rainbow's end, all colors will disappear from the world.
I can't believe it, Prof.
I thought it was a joke, too, when I heard it.
A joke?
Oh, sure. And even when Lovingstone told me he had some reliable information about it, I still didn't feel like going with him. I'd heard it all before, but...
What?
Well, Alfred, while I was looking at the rainbow, I began thinking that the legend might be true.
But you are a scientist.
I am.
How could a scientist believe in such a fairy story?
Well, if the pot of gold really does exist, I want to find it.
You're just chasing after rainbows.
Maybe you're right. So do I understand that if I should invite you, you would refuse to come?
Refuse to come?
You don't believe in such silly legends.
Well, if the pot of gold really does exist, I'd like to go and see it for myself.
So, you would chase rainbows?
You might be right.
Would you mind if I came along as well?
Of course you can come, Hank.
I would like to come too, Professor.
By all means.
Oh, thank you very much. And what is in the legendary pot, Professor?
According to the legend, there's some gold sand in it.
Gold sand, eh?
It's sand, but each grain is shaped like a star, at least so I heard. But it's real gold.
Oh! He's passed out again.
Don't worry about him. He's got a weakness for shiny things. He was overcome by the thought of what was in that pot.
How would you like to come with us, Winnie? Where to? Where to? Where are we going, Professor?
We're going deep in the heart of the island continent.
Are you prepared to go that far to confirm a tall story? Certainly. Well, I won't. It really is quite absurd. No, it isn't. Your behavior is quite foolish. Foolish?
Oh...
Perhaps I can put it this way, then. When you get a new idea, you just go chasing off in all directions just like children.
¶¶
we are, over the middle of the island continent.
It's a tremendous jungle down there.
Dr. Lovingstone!
Hmm?
Oh!
They are here! That funny thing has come!
That funny thing is the professor's flying machine.
No bumps on landing, Alfred.
I'm not like you, Professor.
Everybody all right?
They look quite okay to me.
Looks like the jungle I've seen in films.
Well, in the movies I've seen, you get attacked by somebody for sure in a place like this.
There are rascals everywhere, and some very rowdy beasts.
Lovingstone?
Uh-huh.
We'll still have to walk once we get there?
No, we'll go on by canoe. It's too soon to be tired.
I'm not used to walking in the jungle.
Thanks, Alfred.
Expeditions aren't easy.
Guess you're right.
Is it worth it?
What did you say, Grubby?
Does the pot of gold really exist?
Dr. Lovingstone said it did for sure, didn't he?
If it didn't exist, this long trek would hardly be worth it, would it?
Are you very tired, then?
I think I'll follow you flying above the trees.
Yeah, that is a good idea.
See you later, then. It feels so good up here.
You there, who are you?
Grabby's my name.
Why are you flying here?
I'm with other people.
Well, where are these other people?
They're walking in the jungle.
Walking? In the jungle? Well, I'm blown. What an odd thing to do.
I think I'll walk too. Gosh, whatever's going on down there?
You just went and woke us up from a good sleep, you did.
Oh, we're sorry about what happened. We didn't mean it. Please accept our apologies, will you?
Your apologies will never make up for my lost sleep.
Oh, what else can we do then?
Let me have this little chat.
What? What are you going to do?
You are just about the right size, and I don't think you'll get hurt if you fall.
Whatever are these people talking about, Dr. Lovingstone?
I don't know. Inhabitants of the jungle can be really wild, so I think we should do as they say, just to pacify them.
But that's irresponsible!
What are you going on about? Do we get him or don't we?
Oh, yes, you do. Please be nice to him.
But of course! Come here, son! Oh, you lot, we'll have a game with a duck.
A game with a duck?
Oops.
one more round, gentlemen. Then we'll have to be moving on.
How'd you feel, Alfred?
My head's in a whirl.
We'll be at the lake in a few minutes, so hang in there.
I hope there won't be anybody there who'll play with me as a boat, Dad.
No one has ever come this far into the jungle.
Why ever not? It looks peaceful.
A giant beast has been seen.
A beast?
What sort of a beast?
Huh?
Didn't you see it, Yonola?
I didn't see it clearly, but there is a great big beast in this lake.
Are you scared?
I am scared.
Ah, Alfred.
Let's hope, then. It plays no games. So far, nothing's happened.
Maybe there isn't any beast.
Yes, there is.
Maybe it's sleeping today.
Are we getting close to our destination, Dr. Lovingstone?
We'll leave the boat at the lake and walk by the river to the Rainbow's End. I can't wait to see that pot of gold with real gold inside.
Mm.
Oh.
What is that sound?
Sound?
But didn't you hear a roar just now?
Oh, can't hear anything now.
There it is.
Please come back here.
Oh, no, we won't.
Oh, come on, we are now. What's going on? Oh, no. Oh, please, no, not that. Oh, no. Anything. They're in trouble down there. I'm no coward, but I just don't know how to rescue them.
We are certainly grateful that you rescued us from drowning in the river, but is it necessary to tie us up? Do you think I could talk to your chief, I wonder?
It's odd these people don't speak. What kind of people are they, Dr. Lovingstone?
I don't know. I haven't been introduced to any of them. What about you, Yonela?
It worries me very much if they are the kind of folk that people say they are.
What kind? I've seen a similar scene in a film.
I wonder what that big pot over there is for.
You seem to be headman of this place, so what are you going to do with us? It's not a very nice way to treat visitors.
You be quiet.
Oh, you do understand our language.
I'm telling you to be quiet.
Does he really understand me?
You be quiet or we'll change the order, starting with you.
The order for what?
Our soup pot.
Ah! So that's what the pot's for. You are going to use us to make your soup?
Yes, sir. We have an old saying which says that what comes down the waterfall finishes up in the soup pot.
Surely that's all rather out of date now, isn't it?
Not for us. We're old-fashioned. There's me talking again. We have an old saying. Silence before the altar.
You spoke a little earlier about the right order.
That's right. According to tribal law, the first one is you.
Me? Why me? Oh, Libby!
Oh, Fred!
Help!
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 What a great discovery. I'm sure there's a pot of gold over there. What can we do about it now?
Whoa, it's getting hot.
Alfred.
Somebody please, help, help, help.
Alfred is so merry, so very, very merry. He's even bright and cheerful, and things are going wrong. Whenever he's downhearted, 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 the feeling's never with him for very, very long. Young Alfred is quite sporty, he likes to be quite sporty. He's very much like any normal, lively lad. Sometimes he can be naughty, but even when he's naughty, you'll find he's never, never, ever really bad. And you've been with us and heard our refrain. We'll hope you come along soon and join us again.